Bivur Tov from Yerushalayim. It is Motzei Shabbat after Shabbat Chanukah. Shabbat Chanukah is the Shabbat that falls during Chanukah. We have a special Haftarah that comes from the Prophet Zechariah. The setting for the Prophet Zechariah happens right there, inside what is now the Dome of the Rock. The Dome of the Rock was built in the 8th century, not as a mosque. It's not a mosque. People don't go in there to pray. In fact, if you look inside, and the main feature of the Dome of the Rock is the Evan Hashtia, the foundation stone. That is the stone from which the entire world was created, and it is the stone that was the floor of the Kodesh Kodeshim, the Holy of Holies, where the Kohen Gadol, the high priest, would go once a year on Yom HaKippurim, Yom Kippur. On Yom Kippur, we usually think of that as the final day, the final sealing of judgment for all of Am Yisrael and the entire world. But according to Hasidut, the final sealing of the judgment that happened on Rosh Hashanah doesn't fully take place on Yom HaKippurim. It fully takes place during Chanukah. And the fact that we're reading about the Kohen Gadol on Chanukah really drives this point home. Imagine the Kohen Gadol, Yeshua, he's just come back from exile and he's standing in the heavenly tribunal, and on his left is the Satan, accusing him of having been neglectful of his Kohen duties during exile. And he's pictured and personified, Yeshua is, the Kohen Gadol, as wearing filthy Kohen Gadol garments, the Big Day Kuhuna. They're wrinkled, they're filthy, they're disgusting. They're not what the Kohen Gadol should be wearing to achieve a kapara, an atonement for all of Am Yisrael. What is all of Am Yisrael going to do to achieve a kapara if the person who's supposed to be giving them that kapara is himself in question and in judgment? And on the other side of the heavenly tribunal are the malachim, the advocating angels, those who are standing before him saying, no, it's okay that he has not been perfectly up to the perfection that we would normally expect. This, they call him, is a firebrand snatched from the midst of the fire. We have to make concessions here. And who does Hashem listen to? The malachim that are advocating for him. They dress him in brand new Big Day Kuhuna, and they lead him and they put him in front of the Evan Hashtia to make the kapara now for all of Am Yisrael. And it says in Zechariah a very fascinating thing about what is happening in this scene in the Kodesh HaKodeshim in front of the Evan Hashtia. It says that there are 7 eyes on the Evan Hashtia, which is code for the entire world watching what is happening in this one particular place. How does that relate today? After October 7th, every single nation, prime minister, and person on the planet decided to have an opinion about what's happening in Israel. Hamas called it Operation Al-Aqsa Flood. What's Al-Aqsa? Nickname for the entire compound, the entire Har HaBayit. What's that got to do with anything? They know internally that the Evan Hashtia, the Dome of the Rock, Har HaBayit, is the center point of all of universal spirituality. And that's what they're seeking to control. And the prophets know this, and that's why they're talking about it. So we need to see where Zechariah goes. He says that when all 7 eyes of the world are on this stone, then the Tzemach will come. And the Tzemach is, as you guessed it, the Mashiach. And when he says that the Tzemach comes, then he uses this specific phrase, then every neighbor will call to their other neighbors. They will invite each person under his vine, under his fig tree. And that is the language of the Messianic redemption, the Geula. But it doesn't come automatically. We need to look at the parallel in Micha, the prophet Micha, to understand where this is going. The prophet Micah in chapter 4 says the following. He says that it will be in the end of days that the mountain of Hashem and the temple of Hashem will become the most prominent of mountains. This doesn't mean height-wise. If you look behind Har HaBayit, there's Har HaZeitim, the Mount of Olives. It's higher than Har HaBayit. That's not what it's talking about. It's talking about as far as importance. The importance of Har HaBayit, the importance of the temple, is what Zechariah and now Micha are talking about. And why is it the most prominent of places? Zechariah says all eyes are towards it, but Micha goes even further. He says not only are people's eyes towards it, like we saw in my other video where when we pray, we set our intention and attention towards this holy place, but more than that, the peoples, all nations, begin to stream towards this place. It says explicitly that they will say one to another, come, let us go to the mountain of Hashem, to the temple of the God of Jacob, and learn his ways. Learn the Torah from the Kohanim, which is, as we mentioned, the main purpose of the Beit HaMikdash, to centralize in one place the teaching of the Torah of Hashem. When that happens, we have the famous line that the nations will beat their swords into plowshares. They will no longer lift up sword one nation against another, because each neighbor will be inviting his other neighbor under his fig tree, under his vine. It will be a time of unparalleled peace. How does that happen? It happens by people coming to Har HaBayit. So we tie this together with Yeshua standing in the Kadosh HaKadoshim, right in front of the Evan HaShtiyah, receiving his newly anointed Big Day Kahuna, granting a kapara for all of Am Yisrael during this Hanukkah season, with the nations coming and all of the Jews coming to one place together, every person living at peace with one another. This is the vision of the prophets, and this is what we seek when we go up to Har HaBayit. One step at a time, little by little, when we take those steps to come to Har HaBayit, to see the place where Hashem has set his name forever, we will see the temple manifested.